Till now, we have gathered decent knowledge of real power and apparent power, and now we will understand what is complex power and reactive power. So in this way, we will have the knowledge of all the four powers: real power, apparent power, complex power, and reactive power. And the first thing we will do is to understand the definition of complex power, and then I will show you how you can derive the complex power following the correct method. And finally, we will have discussion on various important points related to the complex power. So let us move on to the definition of complex power. The product of the RMS voltage phasor and the complex conjugate of the RMS current phasor is known as the complex power. So in this definition, we are required to focus on two quantities. First one is the RMS voltage phasor, which means the phasor of the voltage corresponding to the RMS value, and therefore I will represent it like this: V phasor sub RMS. And the second quantity is complex conjugate of the RMS current phasor. RMS current phasor means phasor of the current corresponding to the RMS value. So we will have I phasor sub RMS, and then we need the complex conjugate. So I will put asterisk here, and when we multiply these two quantities, we will have the complex power. And now I will take one impedance Z, and let us say that across this impedance, the voltage is equal to Vt, and through this impedance, the current is equal to It, and the voltage Vt is having the RMS value V RMS, and the phase angle is theta V. And when we write this information together, we will have the RMS voltage phasor. RMS voltage phasor, it will be equal to V RMS angle theta V. Now moving on to the current we are having. Current It is having the RMS value I RMS, and the phase angle is theta I. And we can have the RMS current phasor from here. RMS current phasor will be equal to I RMS angle theta I. Now from here we will have the complex conjugate of the RMS current phasor. The complex conjugate of the RMS current phasor, it will be equal to I RMS angle negative of theta I. And from this definition, we know that if we multiply the RMS voltage phasor and the complex conjugate of the RMS current phasor, we will have the complex power. We will have the complex power upon multiplication of RMS voltage phasor and the complex conjugate of the RMS current phasor. And therefore, we can say that the complex power is equal to V RMS angle theta V multiplied to I RMS angle negative of theta I. The magnitudes will get multiplied and the angles will get added, and therefore the complex power will be equal to V RMS multiplied to I RMS. This is the magnitude, and the angle will be theta V minus theta I. Now I will explain how you can have the derivation of complex power, and for this we will use the formula of average power. We know average power is equal to half Vm Im cos theta V minus theta I. Cos theta V minus theta I with this signifies that this is the real part of a complex number. And therefore, we can say that the average power is equal to the real part of half Vm Im e power j theta V minus theta I. We can write this exponential as e power j theta V multiplied to e power negative of j theta I. So in the next step, we will have the average power equal to the real part of 1 by 2 Vm Im e power j theta v multiplied to e power negative of j theta I. And now I will rearrange this a little and I will have the average power equal to the real part of Vm over root 2 e power j theta v multiplied to Im over root 2 e power negative of j theta I. Now these two are written in the exponential form of the complex number. We can have the polar form as well. So in the next step, we will have the average power equal to the real part of V RMS. We can write Vm over root 2 as V RMS, and the angle will be theta V multiplied to I RMS, and the angle will be negative of theta I. Now understand what is happening here. We are having the average power or the real power equal to the real part of this value. And this means this value is the complex value. Why? Because we calculate the real or the imaginary part of a complex number. And therefore, this complex value is our complex power. And we can write it as the RMS voltage phasor. This is, you can see from here, is the RMS voltage phasor. And this one here is our conjugate of the RMS current phasor. The conjugate of the RMS current phasor. So you can see that we have derived the complex power. And from here we can say that VRMS multiplied to IRMS is the magnitude of the complex power. This is the magnitude of the complex power. And we also know that VRMS multiplied to IRMS is the apparent power. So the magnitude of the complex power is the apparent power. This is important. And we know apparent power is measured in volt amperes. And this is the reason complex power is also measured in volt amperes. Now moving on to the next step, we will write the complex power equal to VRMS, IRMS, VRMS, IRMS cos theta V minus theta I plus J VRMS, IRMS sin theta V minus theta I. And let us say this is our equation number 1. The complex power may be expressed in terms of the load impedance Z. We know the load impedance is equal to V phasor over I phasor, or we can say that it is equal to the RMS voltage phasor over the RMS current phasor. And this implies the RMS voltage phasor is equal to the RMS current phasor multiplied to the impedance Z. And now I will put RMS voltage phasor equal to this here in this expression, and we will have the complex power equal to the conjugate of RMS current phasor multiplied to the RMS current phasor multiplied to the impedance. From here we will have the apparent power equal to the square of RMS current. From here we will have a square of RMS current. We know this property of the complex numbers. And then we will multiply Z to this. And this is what we have as the complex power. And we know the impedance Z is having the two parts. First one is the resistance offered by the impedance, which is the real part. And the second one is the reactance offered by the impedance, which is the imaginary part. So we can write the complex power equal to I RMS square multiplied to R plus JX. And from here we will have the complex power equal to I RMS square multiplied to R plus J I RMS square multiplied to X. Now it is clear that I RMS square multiplied to R is the real part of the complex power, and we call it average power or the real power. And I RMS square multiplied to the reactance X is the imaginary part of the complex power, and we call it reactive power. So finally, we can express the complex power equal to the average power plus J, the reactive power. The average power is the real power, and it depends on the resistance of the load impedance. And the reactive power depends on the reactance offered by the load impedance. The reactive power measures the energy exchange between the source and the reactive part of the load, and it is measured in VAR, which is volt ampere reactive. We measure it in VAR in order to distinguish it from the average or real power, which is measured in watts. Now, when you compare this equation with our first equation, you will find the average power P is equal to VRMS IRMS cos theta V minus theta I, and the reactive power Q, it is equal to VRMS IRMS sin theta V minus theta I. And when this reactive power is equal to zero, this implies the load is purely resistive and the power factor is equal to one. When Q is greater than zero, this implies the load is inductive in nature and the power factor will be lagging. And when Q is less than zero, the load will have the capacitive nature and the power factor will lead.